Greyhound racing talks a lot about welfare. However, I think they're focused on their own welfare. They're not focused or concerned on the health, happiness or safety of the animals.
Lisa White's passion for greyhounds began after an impromptu visit to the pound 2 decades ago.
There was a beautiful blue dog sitting in one of the kennels at the pound, and the pound keeper said, "Oh, don't look at that dog, she's here to be destroyed." That dog's little face remained in my mind, and I went back and I got that greyhound out of the pound.
The following year, Lisa founded Friends of the Hound, a charity that saves ex-racing dogs from euthanasia.
We are still taking dogs with quite severe injuries that nobody else will take because we can and will help them.
They get a thorough once-over by rescuers and vets, and adopting families get checked out too. Bob ran his last race in June and found his forever home 3 weeks ago.
Bob is a new addition to our family and he's taken all our hearts already. He's the most gentle, placid, loving, big guy, and he loves pats. What else does he love?
Well, he likes cuddles.
He definitely loves his cuddles. And he just likes hanging out with us.
Each year, up to 11,000 greyhound pups are bred by trainers looking for speed. Those that don't stack up are discarded. Initial wastage, as the trainers call it. Those that do make it to the track are at significant risk of injury, with up to 200 dogs injured during race meetings each week. These days, more people are putting their names on the adoption list, but for a long time, Lisa struggled to convince people that greyhounds were a family dog.
I guess I had the general misconception about greyhounds, and yes, I was quite shocked when John came home and suggested that we might like to consider a greyhound.
But all that changed when Lisa matched Ian and John with their first greyhound 5 years ago. And now the couple has three.
They're so sedate, gentle, social. Most times they don't bark, they're just cruisy.
They're good with kids, they're good with other dogs. Says a dog world's biscuits, they're good.
Friends of the Hound has rehomed just over 3,500 greyhounds since its inception, of which over 850 of those dogs has come through my place. I stopped counting several years ago and it was 800 then, so yeah, but they're worth it.
And a few of those dogs have stuck around at Lisa's place for good.
We have 10 dogs at our place at the moment, but only 4 of them are foster dogs. Unfortunately, you get the odd greyhound that you think, oh, that one's never going to go into a home, it's too timid, or if there's some health issue, they end up staying.
Lisa, look, she's just been amazing.
She's just an incredibly amazing, driven human being.
It's been a sacrifice, but for me, I feel like I need to do more because there's still so many dogs out there and racing still exists.
Greyhounds are beautiful dogs.
Really. I love them. I've got a few friends that have rescued greyhounds and they do huge farts. That's something they do. they look so cute and they'll like, give you the eyes, but they fart and they smell so bad. But that doesn't mean they're not nice dogs.
She didn't mention that.
Yeah. It's kind of, you know, promoting, but this is a warning. They fart.
It's like, you don't have to give us the dark side of every story, mate. It's fine. If you'd like to know how you can help Friends of the Hound, head to our website for details.